everyone. Welcome to Church at Home.
Yes, and a special welcome if it's your first time joining us today. We are very glad that you've tuned in. So let us know in the comments somewhere that you're here because we want to chat. We want to say hello.
For sure. And what a week to join. It's Baptism Sunday this morning. We love baptisms.
We do.
We love them.
Yeah. Oh my gosh. My favorite part is hearing literally every individual one is a story of a life change.
I know. I love baptism. It really inspires my faith and encourages me to keep going.
Mm. I saw your baptism. That's
did
good.
You? Yep. You did.
Years ago. It's great.
Did it inspire you?
It inspired me.
As it should.
And these will too.
Hey, we also love building community here and creating opportunities for people to connect in. Mm. So there's heaps you can get involved with. We have play groups for young families. We have life groups meeting in people's homes where we just get to eat good food and do life together. Yep. And we also have an active ministry where you can get moving.
Yes, and Active has just launched a new basketball comp. 3-on-3.
3-on-3.
Yes, it's all the rage at the moment. It's fun, it's social, it's fast paced, and it's an easy way to just grab a couple of mates or family members for some fun. Registrations are closing July 2nd, so get in quick.
July 2nd. Create a team, grab your buddies, and go, sign up.
Teams of 3 on court and 1 sub,
so you
and 3 mates.
Love it,
you're
that's so fun.
Mates, yeah.
Really cool.
Send messages, come on.
Come on, let's do basketball.
Yeah.
And for a bit of awesome family fun, for those that don't know, we have a theatre company here at Gateway, and we love putting on performances each year, and our youth school holiday program, Broadway in a Week, this school holidays is doing The Addams Family.
Oof.
So it's gonna be so good. It's a story about family and radical acceptance, which will be fun for everyone. But really, Broadway in a Week is just an amazing thing to witness. Mm. These young people choreograph, block, and learn a show in a week and perform it at the end of the week. So it's pretty phenomenal. It's pretty crazy. So make sure you get tickets and cheer them on.
It's crazy. I reckon if I had a whole year, I wouldn't remember all the lines that these kids remember. It's amazing.
Is that how terrible? His memory is terrible.
So. It's not good.
Yeah.
Like the quality overall is just like out of this world.
Yeah.
Yeah, and our show Little Mermaid Junior, I was nominated for an award.
Nominated for 5 awards.
5 awards.
5 Musical Gilded Victoria Awards.
Well, that's how good it is.
I know,
it's
amazing.
Actually,
go get down there, watch The Addams Family.
Let's get around it. Another way we like to support each other is through prayer. So if there's anything that you'd like prayer for, it can be big, it can be small. We have a team of people who faithfully pray each week over every single prayer request that is sent in. That is so personal. So please do let us know how we can support you in prayer this week.
Hmm. Love that. Hey, a massive thank you to everybody who gives throughout the week. Mm. We just want to say that we appreciate your generosity so much. And we know it's not always easy to give, but this church exists and can do what it does in this community and beyond because of that faithfulness that you have. So thank you so much.
Incredible. Yeah, so great. And before we dive into baptisms.
I get it.
We have 10 people deciding to declare their faith in front of their family and friends this morning.
Wow, 10?
10.
So good.
So that's super exciting. And that's 10 stories of lives that have been changed by Jesus.
Yeah.
Incredible. So many of us have chosen to follow Jesus, who have done that, know what it's like to daily have our lives transformed for the better. And some would say that they've been given a second chance. Some may say, they've been given a fresh start. They might say it's like finally coming alive to their true self.
Mm.
And for many of us, we would say we've been made new.
Mm.
And as these people go down under the water and are brought up out of the tank, it symbolizes the washing away of our old self and the beginning of the new life that we have in Jesus. So we pray your faith is refreshed this morning as you see the grace of God moving in each and every story and as we witness these people following Jesus into the waters of baptism.
I'm so pumped.
Oh, it's exciting.
It's going to be so good.
Let's get into worship.
You gave us the truth right here in your word. You're everything we need. Hi, I am Belle and I'm in Year 9 at Bayside Christian College. I was raised in a Christian household, but I often struggled with my faith. My parents got a divorce when I was young, so I alternated between houses every week. I lost family, had school problems, friend problems, and also got bullied. For a long time, I turned from God because how could an all-loving God let that happen to me? But now I know that God has a plan set up for me, and everything that happens in His plan has made me who I am today.
Hi, my name is Elshin and I have been part of the Gateway family for around 10 years. Faith has always been a very personal journey to me, but I am tired of being shy in my faith. This is my declaration that I am all in for the Lord no matter what. One of the biggest ways that I connect to God is through music, and a song that I've had on my heart for a while is Jaira by Elevation Worship. In that it says, "It doesn't take a trophy to make you proud. And if He watches over every sparrow, how much more does He love you?" And for this reason, I'm ready to take this next step in my faith journey. I grew up in a house with strong Christian values and lived in a country, South Africa, that shared these. When my family moved to Australia, we had to rebuild everything, and it was evident to me that my faith would be publicly challenged. The biggest eye-opener for me was starting high school in a foreign country, as my school friends questioned my faith daily. At this time, I had started going to youth and was trying to get my friends to come along to understand why I was the way that I was and why my faith was so important to me.
Hi, my name is Brett and I'm getting baptized to take my next steps with God. From a young age, I always experienced going to church every Sunday, so God has always been part of my life. I grew up with my mum and her family, and they have always been there for me. But I have never known my dad, which left a lot of questions in my life as I got older. Ever since I was little, I dealt with a really bad cough. When I was 8, the night before school camp, I had a coughing fit to the point where I stopped breathing, and I was rushed to hospital and treated for severe croup. That night, I was surrounded by doctors and nurses trying to treat me and get me better. Looking back, I know God was in that hospital room with His hand on me and my mum, getting me through that and helping the doctors heal me. Thankfully, today I no longer have to deal with it, so I have the doctors and God to thank.
Back in 2021, I was invited to youth by one of my best friends, Summer Buckley. While I was there, I met people and had a memorable time with God. Now, whenever I have the chance, I come to youth. Youth has been the biggest part of my Christianity journey, and now all because I went to youth, I'm getting baptized.
In Year 9, I started going to Flinders, where the people I had met on camp became some of the closest people in my life, still to this day. I'm so thankful for every one of them, as they have truly showed me what a faithful life with Jesus looks like, and they have supported me every step of the way. During this time, I felt like I had to be completely perfect or have a crazy testimony to be baptized. See, I never had a life before meeting Jesus and a life after meeting Jesus. I've always had Jesus.
I started coming to Gateway Church at the end of 2022 after I was invited by my auntie. I wasn't keen on going at first, but after going along, I came back again and again. Then at the start of this year, I went to my first Camp No Fear. It was really good, fun, and messy. I wasn't expecting to be so tired by the end. At camp, the band played the song Reckless Love. I love the part of the song where it says, "The overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God. It chases me down fossil unfound leaves of the 99. I love these words because they talk about the story in the Bible where the shepherd leaves the 99 sheep to look for the one lost one. And when he finds it, he puts it on his shoulders and has a party with his friends to celebrate him finding the sheep.
I remember a specific time at youth where they asked everyone that if they wanted to come up the front and accept God into their lives as their Lord and Savior, that this was their time. I remember being so nervous, not knowing if I would look stupid or silly, but I went up anyway. Immediately, I felt God's presence and I knew I wanted to get baptized to help with my final step in my faith journey.
This year, I had the privilege to be on the camp band, which was something I have dreamt of since I was a little Year 7. Being up on that stage, seeing all of the youth and leaders in their different faith journeys, made me realize that I didn't need to prove anything or be perfect to take this next step. God already has a chair waiting for me with my name on it. All I had to do was trust.
The night I heard that song, I decided to give my life to God. This was one of the biggest decisions in my life, and so far I haven't looked back. I know that in the moment I said yes to God and accepted Him into my life, He was having a party in heaven, and I was one of those lost sheep, like in the Bible.
Sometimes I worry about the future and what is yet to come, but I know that God is taking care of me and that He will give me peace and guidance no matter what. I want to thank everyone that helped me find God, find myself, and most importantly, find peace in my relationship with Him.
John 15 verse 5 says, "I am the sprouting vine and you're my branches. As you live in union with me as your source, fruitfulness will stream from within you." Baptism is the outward symbol of the internal change that God brings in us through the world of Jesus, and I am ready to take this next step. Galatians 2 verse 20 says, "My old identity has been co-crucified with Christ and no longer lives. And now the essence of this new life is no longer mine, for the Anointed One lives His life through me. We live in union as one. My new life is empowered by the faith of the Son of God who loves me so much that He gave Himself for me, dispensing His life into mine."
I believe that baptism is the next step in my journey with God. I've decided to get baptized to publicly declare to my family, friends and church that I want to follow God for the rest of my life. I want to thank my cousin Ben for taking me to youth and supporting me along my journey, to my auntie Teresa for inviting me to youth, and to my mum for always being there for me and supporting me.
I am Belle and I have been made new.
I am Elshin and I have been made new.
I am Brett and I have been made new.
Hi, I'm Leanne, and I've been a Christian most of my life. I was blessed to go to Sunday school with my mum, join a church youth group, and met Jesus when I was 16 at a youth conference while singing the song, "I Surrender All." He has been my friend ever since. He is the only one who I can talk to at any time. He is the only one who I know will never let me down. He has always been with me through the highs and the lows of my life. He has provided me with a strong Christian husband to do life with. He was with me as I gave birth to and raised my three beautiful children. He was with me when my dad died. I felt His overwhelming peace that only He can give. He has blessed me with a lovely son-in-law and two gorgeous grandchildren and my son's gorgeous girlfriend. He has shown me His amazing love and grace. While people may walk away from me when I make mistakes, He never gives up on me. He continues to walk with me regardless of my faults. Instead, He forgives me time and time again and gently guides me to be more like Him. He has given me opportunities for work and to serve Him in the church community. Life has certainly never been dull. He has shown and taught me generosity and how to be grateful for what I have. I've seen Him heal people and recently experienced some healing myself.
Hi, I'm Eleanor. I've always grown up in a Christian home, always gone to church and always known of God. But it wasn't until recently that I started to properly have a relationship with Him. To get baptized, I thought you always had to have this amazing story of that one defining moment where God changed your life. I've always thought that I wasn't good enough or ready to get baptized, so I just kept waiting for that one perfect moment.
Hi, I'm Harry, and today I'm getting baptized to declare my love for Jesus and to lay a foundation for a life with Him. I'm extremely grateful to have grown up in a Christian home. My family went to church most weeks, and my parents and siblings were expressive and taught me about Jesus' love and His sacrifice for us. I've never faced tremendous adversity in my life. I don't think there was ever a point where I was changed 180. I believe this is because God has always been a part of my life, but I haven't always known of God.
Hi, I'm Connor. I've been a Christian since day one, knowing God my whole life, thanks to my parents. I knew God, but I never really knew Him intimately. I would pray very rarely and almost never picked up my Bible. Church was just the thing I went to on Sundays because I always did, and that's what my parents did. I was always in a hurry to go home, hurrying Mum and Dad up, trying to drag them to the car. Now Mum and Dad are the ones struggling to get me out the church doors. The church was always a very familiar place though, with Mum and Dad being highly involved. I always knew a lot of people and even more people always knew me. You could say I was quite famous. Looking back, I can see God's hand in all the good influence I had when I was younger that helped shape me into the person I am today, which I'm truly thankful for.
Jesus has shown me love, kindness, care, and acceptance through his people. He has spoken to me through his word, visions, dreams, people, sermons, and books. He's always come through for me. There have been several significant moments in my life, but it would be impossible to share them all. Therefore, I have decided just to share two of the most recent that have led me to be baptized. The first one was a few years ago when I became extremely busy and overcommitted. I was working in a stressful job, had multiple family commitments, and was heavily involved in my previous church. I was trying to keep everyone happy and lost myself and who I am in the process. I became burnt out and felt numb and unable to show or feel compassion or empathy for others. I lost my joy. My heart started to become hard and I was becoming very cynical. During this time, there was also a lot of instability within our church community. This was a painful and stressful time for me. I experienced feelings of loss and grief, as this had been my church community for 40 years. It was where I had met and married my supportive and loving husband, raised our children, made lifelong friends, and been heavily involved in service.
When I moved from England to Australia, I started going to primary school at Flinders and Gateway Church. At school we did Bible studies, but I didn't really listen to the message, I just looked forward to the craft. Mum would play Christian music in the car and would drag me to church every Sunday, where I went to God's Own, and there I learnt that I wanted to be forever friends with Jesus. Sometimes I would go to big church and just stand there during the worship because I was too embarrassed to sing the lyrics.
I believe that God has performed many miracles over my family and many of my friends. I've seen God heal and bless and save. When I was about 8 years old, my older sister Tilly went to the hospital with severe depression and anxiety. This was an extremely dark time for my family, and this is when God was with us most. I was only eight, I was naive, and I was oblivious. For so long in my childhood, I never understood what was wrong with Tilly. I sometimes even felt jealous that my parents never told me. This was a time of extreme fear for my family, and they've told me that the night that she was admitted to hospital was one of the hardest nights of their lives. But this was when our faith as a family strengthened.
I wasn't really connected to God until I started coming to youth on Fridays. Learning more and more about God, I started getting more and more curious about his presence, love, forgiveness, and power. Still though, I only really turned to him when things started to get dark in the valley moments.
Jesus was there in my pain. I felt it was time for a fresh start and a new church home. God confirmed this in a dream. One night during lockdown, when I was sitting quietly in Jesus' presence, he showed me a vision of being in the wilderness where it was dry and lifeless. This is where I was feeling spiritually. In the vision, Jesus took my hand and led me out of the wilderness to a beautiful lake full of life and beauty. The water was flowing, filled with colourful fish, and surrounded by healthy, lush green grass and magnificent trees. I could hear him gently saying, "Come and get back into the living water with me." I then read the Bible verse, "Forget the former things, do not dwell on the past. See, I am doing a new thing, now it springs up. Do you not perceive it? I am making a way in the wilderness and streams in the wasteland." Isaiah 43:18-19.
In 2021, we went back into lockdown and I didn't get to go on my first Camp No Fear, but I was secretly relieved. During lockdown, I struggled a lot to find the motivation to go to youth online and didn't join very often. My faith took a hit and I distanced myself from God. In 2022, youth went back, but I really went and I felt isolated and alone. I was scared of what people would think of me and ended up distancing myself from everyone there.
I first came to youth in youth online during lockdown when my brother Joey was leading. But it took me a while to get used to it and I didn't have much fun. But I came back at the start of year 7 with my best mate Sebby Blakeney. We came every week and started to make friends, and I've been going ever since. At the start of my youth journey, I came because of my friends. But moments with just me and God were scarce. In year 8, I became very insecure. I was judging myself and I sometimes even hated myself.
Still didn't feel like I had a strong relationship with God until Camp No Fear came around. On the third night, in the night rally, while the band were playing worship, a circle of people formed, our arms around each other. Some of them I'd known my whole life, others I'd never spoken to before, but in that circle, it didn't matter. We were all singing and rocking and crying together. Now I understand why it's called Cry Night. In that moment, Harry started to pray for us all. Somehow, without anyone saying a word to him, he knew exactly what each and every one of us needed to hear. I knew it couldn't just be Harry in that moment. I knew God was working through him. I felt a wave of love flow over me, and I knew that God was there looking over me, and he always had been.
My second story to share is more recent. In the last 18 months, I have struggled with several health issues. Like a lot of people, I have had COVID twice, which has exacerbated my asthma and affected my energy levels. I've had chronic back pain for many years due to my nursing career, but last year I suffered 2 back spasms and the osteoarthritis in my hands and feet got worse. Then in November, I noticed my eyesight was slightly impaired in my right eye. After a few tests, my optometrist told me I had papilledema, which is pressure on the optic nerve, and needed to see my GP ASAP. This was of serious concern as I could have had a brain tumour or intracranial hypertension, both are life-threatening conditions. After an MRI, multiple eye tests, blood tests and appointments with ophthalmologists and neurologists, the cause was unable to be found. 2 months later, the papilledema had resolved. Jesus again was with me through all the tests and uncertainty. I am certain Jesus healed me.
However, in 2023, I finally went on my first Camp No Fear, although this was not my choice. I was extremely nervous and leading up to it, pleaded with my mum and dad not to send me. But as soon as I got there, I started having lots of fun. Eden Vass was such a good friend to me and she really helped me through my nerves. She was always there for me when I needed her at camp. On the third night of camp, a leader prayed for a big group of year nines I was a part of and they referred to us as a waterhole. She explained that animals of all different species and places come to the waterhole and drink from it, then go back to where they came from, but they always end up coming back for more water. So even though we're all at different schools and different friendship groups and haven't been consistently connected as a group in the past, we can have these moments of being together and supporting each other when we're at youth and camp. This group of people meant so much to me and helped me to open up and feel like I could be vulnerable. This was the first real time God spoke to me, but I still didn't feel ready. A couple months after, I watched some of my close friends get baptized and during worship, I felt God speak to me. In this moment, I didn't really listen, but now I can tell that that was the moment he was telling me to do this today. I had always struggled with not feeling good enough and like I can't do anything. I never really told anyone about this because it seemed too little and silly against other people's struggles. This was the main thing holding me back from baptism.
At the end of 2022 was when I really started to put my hands up in worship and I really started to get to know God. I began having more spiritual encounters. This maturity in faith came just before my first Camp No Fear, but camp was when I truly met God. Camp No Fear Week was probably the best week of my life. The community, the games, I was being who I wanted to be. On night 2, during the worship, I opened myself fully to God and I bawled my eyes out the entire time. I cried for God, I cried for myself, I felt emotions that I'd never felt before. But most of all, I was crying for my sister. I felt that all the obliviousness that I had had towards her sickness was finally being wiped away. I felt that I finally understood her anguish. God gave me her tears. I bawled and I bawled, but all that I was feeling was the emotions that she felt every day. On the final night of camp was when God worked through me. When everyone else was crying, was when I prayed for them. God guided me to pray for so many people. I felt that I finally saw God. I now believe that this is my spiritual gift, utilizing my words to share the word of God with others.
As it says in Isaiah 43:2, when you pass through the waters, I will be with you. And when you pass through the rivers, they will not sweep over you. When you walk through the fire, you will not be burned. The flames will not set you ablaze. More and more tears of joy started to roll down my face and I had the biggest smile ever. That night he opened my eyes to who he really was and even till now, that was the best day I've ever had. Ever since that night, I've continued to strengthen my relationship with God, reading my Bible every night and praying multiple times a day. But I still didn't feel ready to get baptized. It felt scary, and I would tell myself, I'm not there yet. I'm not in that stage of my faith. I'm not a good enough Christian. But then last Easter Sunday baptisms, God spoke to me and I realized, baptism isn't a stage or a milestone you have to reach in your faith. Rather, it's a dedication to my faith and relationship with God, a declaration that I love and follow God in the highest highs and the lowest lows, even though I'm far from perfect and far from the best Christian.
The last few years have been some of the toughest times of my life. I have struggled with physical, spiritual, and emotional pain. I have battled with unforgiveness, grief, and a loss of self-esteem and purpose. I have realized how much I need Jesus. I fear for where I actually would be if I didn't know him. I have felt stuck and lost during both of these stories, but Jesus has remained faithful to me and always shown me a way forward. Many times he has encouraged me with the verse in Jeremiah 29:11, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you a hope and a future." I have hung on to this promise. Jesus has been gently nudging me to look up and keep my eyes on him. I am getting baptized because Jesus has asked me to, and I want to trust him more with my life. I want to go deeper with Jesus and continue doing life with him.
I know I'll always struggle with these problems, but I'm tired of facing them alone without God. I never want to feel isolated from him again, and I have begun to learn to listen to God in these moments. A Bible verse that I love is from Isaiah 41 verse 10, and it says, "So do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you, and I will uphold you with my righteous right hand." To me, this verse means that God will always be by my side, and I don't have to worry that he will leave me. I'm still on my journey with God, but I'm excited to make this step in my faith.
After camp, I felt like a new person, and I've been pursuing positivity and evangelism in my everyday. I feel so much closer with God, and I'm working towards becoming more like Jesus. I know now that the pain in our family were seeds planted in my faith, and Camp No Fear was where those seeds sprouted. And I'm so thankful that my family was such a healthy soil for those seeds to grow. I want to thank my parents, Mum and Dad, for always teaching me and supporting me. Thank you to my siblings, Hannah, for being so generous, Joey, for always being there as one of my closest friends, and Tilly for teaching me so many virtues like gratitude, optimism, and maturity. Thank you to Sebi for being my youth partner. Thank you to Jesse for being the wisest person I know. Thank you to all my friends from youth and school who have always been there for me for a deeper conversation. And thank you to God for everything.
I am Connor, and I have been made new.
I am Leanne, and I have been made new.
I am Eleanor, and I have been made new.
I'm Harry, and I have been made new.
Hi, I'm Hannah. I grew up in a Christian household. My grandpa was a pastor, and we went to church every single Sunday, so I was always surrounded by God. Before, it was kind of just a routine thing that happened. I went to kids' church every week, and I had fun, but I wasn't super engaged, and eventually most of the people my age moved away. I guess I kind of knew of God rather than knowing God. And since then, I've been more interested in faith. I've been seeking God's word for my own outside of the church. We started to attend Gateway in late 2019, where I first heard about Camp No Fear. My mum signed me and my sister up, and my faith started to grow after camp in 2020 when I first felt the power of God's presence and I started coming to youth. I met my best friends at camp and I got excited to come to youth and see them every week. This was during Youth Online, which I actually loved as I got to build strong relationships with a few people I talked to every Friday night. And before long, the excitement to talk to them every week turned into excitement to talk about God with them every week.
My name's Emma McCleary, and I've made the choice to get baptized as the next step in my journey with God and to outwardly declare my faith. Today, I am also getting baptized alongside my two older sisters, and I can't put into words how much this means to me. I grew up in a Christian household, my family always attending church and getting involved in church activities. When I was in primary school, I loved the kids program my old church had and was always a part of things that they did. My family moved to Gateway just before the pandemic hit, which resulted in online youth and church. I didn't really enjoy either. I found online youth intimidating as all the girls in my group seemed to know each other from being in God Zone together. Most of them also attended Christian schools, and I felt like they all had stronger relationships with God than I did. Both of these things made me feel like I didn't really fit in.
Hi, I'm Rachel, and I grew up in a Christian household. I always attended church and went to Sunday school. My grandpa was the pastor of our church, and I was always surrounded by God's word. I had many people my age with similar beliefs. However, over time, my church friends moved away or started going to different churches. My friends at school had different beliefs, and I felt myself drifting from God, being unmotivated to go to church and only going because it was part of routine. We made the change to Gateway in 2019, and I loved the atmosphere and vibes it gave off. The first time we attended, the song Waymaker played, and I felt instantly connected. I signed up for Camp No Fear in 2020, and that was the first time I truly felt God's presence. Camp helped me to see other people of the same age engaging with the same faith. It showed me how God can bring people together, and afterwards I found myself getting back in touch with my faith. Before youth, I didn't really have many other Christian friends, and since finding a like-minded, loving community to support me, my relationship with God has only gotten stronger and stronger. There was a dry period of my faith where all my friends would talk about what God was doing for them, but I couldn't feel God doing anything in my life. So I started to wonder if He was really there, even though deep down I always knew He was and always will be. Camp No Fear 2023 reassured me of this. I connected to the worship so deeply on camp, and it was night three when I was listening to the band play the bridge of Waymaker over and over again. Even when I don't see it, you're working, even when I don't feel it, you're working. The whole camp, and specifically that night, was so refreshing for my faith. When we could finally go back to normal youth and church, it was weird for me. I only ever went to youth to see my friends, and I didn't really take it seriously. It was similar at church. The messages bored me, and I always wished I could leave. Instead of being something I liked, going to church became something I dreaded. This was when my faith was at its worst, as I questioned God, wondering if He was even there at all. The turning point for me was Camp No Fear 2023. I had watched my older sisters go to camp in 2020, me being too young to go, and awaited the day I could go too. When I finally got to go, it was amazing. Even though it was only a few days, my faith grew immensely. I made so many connections on this camp, not only with others, but with God. The messages and songs I heard during the night rallies really resonated with me, and I think that's the first time I really felt His presence. However, over lockdown, I found myself falling back into old habits. I didn't pay attention to church online, and I didn't do much about my faith in general. Coming out of lockdown, I didn't really have a relationship with God, and my faith was at an all-time low. Toward the end of year 12, I started listening and making sense of the messages in church. I felt myself reconnecting with God, and I started attending Young Adults Life Group and a Christian Union at uni. I'm now excited to go to church, and I'm eager to learn more about God's word. My relationship with God is a much bigger, more important part of my life now than it ever was. It guides the way I live my life every day, shaping the way I interact with people, engaging in a way the Bible tells me to, rather than acting on how I feel in the situation. I want to show the grace of God through how I live so that I can reveal His goodness to others, and I have more confidence from God to share my faith every day. Ever since then, my relationship with Jesus has grown, and I've started prioritizing my faith. Youth and church are things that I love, and I finally understand the messages I hear. They are both things I look forward to, and now when I'm there, instead of wanting to leave, I wish I could stay for longer. I've found that I really connect with God through worship music, which is something that became obvious to me at Facedown Camp this year. In those 2 days, my faith was strengthened so much, and I finally felt like I actually knew who God was. I've thought about baptism a lot within the last year or so. I knew I always wanted to do it, but I compared myself to other people and their progress and felt as though I wasn't ready, like my faith wasn't as strong or developed as theirs. On April 16th, when Jacob gave his message asking, "What are you waiting for?" I realized, what am I waiting for? The only thing that prevented me from taking this step was that I was comparing my faith journey to other people's. But then I realized we're all different, and if I think I'm ready, then I am. For me, God gives me a divine purpose. He is the reason I live life how I do. He is a friend and comfort to me who is just always there no matter what I am feeling. The same loving God who always has been there and always will be there. I've been thinking about baptism for a little while, and I feel called to take this next step in my faith journey. I'm getting baptized today so I can declare in front of my friends and family my faith in Jesus, which will only grow from here. A song that has really connected with me and urged me to make this decision is Make Room.
It's a song that has been played at church a lot, but one day for me, the lyrics just clicked. The specific lyrics that resonated with me were, "Shake up the ground of all my tradition, break down the walls of all my religion, your way is better." These words encouraged me to dive deeper and take this next step in my faith journey. I know that this isn't the end goal, and I hope I will only continue to grow in my faith and learn more about God.
Knowing my sisters were also thinking of taking this step was encouraging, as I always thought it'd be meaningful to do it together. To me, baptism is an outward expression of my faith, a symbol of how I will live a life devoted to God, serving Him and spreading His word. I'm really excited to build my life around God.
I am Hannah and I've been made new.
I am Emma and I've been made new.
I am Rachel and I've been made new.
My soul will rest in your embrace. I am yours, and you are.
Love that so much. And hey, if from today you're thinking that maybe baptism could be the next step for you in your faith journey, we'd love to chat to you about that. It really is a massive celebration and it's available to all who believe in Jesus. So make sure you let us know and we'd be so happy to walk through that process with you.
Yeah, love that. And what can your response to this service be? It's always great to put an action behind a response. So maybe for you, it's to connect more into community. Maybe that's signing up for a life group or getting a ticket to the show.
Cool.
Or maybe today you want to encourage someone who is brave enough to tell their story. Maybe for you, it's to start giving financially or whatever it is. Make sure you take a moment to lean in and respond.
Yeah, that's great. Well, we'll see you same time next week for Church at Home.
See you then.
Bye.
When I look back, I can see your hand all over my past. Even in the times I'd rather forget, I just can't believe you'd love me like that, love me like that. You never let go, thought I was alone, now I know you were close. I can see it now, you were bringing me home. I just can't believe you'd love me like that, love me like that. Oh, every day gets better when I'm walking with you.